Hey folks, this is Noble Rambler, and welcome to another episode of Let's Play RimWorld. What are we looking at here? I think they're having a little feast over here on a poor deer. And he's just looking on. Yeah, that's too sad to look at. Let's look at something a little more exciting, which is somewhere over here. Where are you? There. That's where we left last time. That's a bigger map than it looks. Anyway, Cassie set off a turtle revenge here. A tortoise is attacking after being harmed. Other tortoises nearby have also become enraged. Jump to location. Okay, yep, I was going to say that's not it, but it is. So, that's where we left off. And Cassie is set to flee. Flee in case of an emergency situation. You can change them to, what is this one? Ignore. Just keep plodding along and not notice that the grizzly's coming up behind you. Or attack aggressively. Yeah, go and kick that grizzly in the face as he charges you. Flee seems to be the more reasonable setting, so we're going to stick with that. Then we can manually manage each situation. So this is going on. It's the only two turtles that I'm aware of in this part of the map. Seems like there was still one more out here somewhere and wandering. So that one is not going to be an issue. Do both of these say manhunting? Where are we? Right here. Attacking Cassie? Attacking Cassie. Okay. It'll be tomorrow when this one reaches her, and next week when this one gets there. So there's not that big of an emergency going on. The biggest emergency is actually sitting right here. Right there. She's going to finish this job to have this beast coming after her. So that's actually the thrill of this episode. As well, another thrill, either this episode or next, we need to pop the box here. We need to see what's in there. We need to find out if they're hiding anything important. You know, like mechs or gold or something. I haven't started yet because there's a few things that I changed in between episodes I wanted to bring up. Carrie gave me a list of things to think about, little tips of things to do. One of them, I've implemented a few of them already. One of them was to stick a stockpile of something that doesn't degrade, but in this case it's under a roof, so it should be fine, of something that is of value that might entice more of the attackers to take the gauntlets to come after and get. So that's something to think about. I stuck squirrel skin in there just because it didn't degrade, but I guess we could put most anything because this is under a roof. But something of value. Let's look around. While we're looking, Radar is trying to go to bed in this messed up room here, and Manuel lives in this one. So I set a bunch of temporary stockpiles out in the hallways at lowest priority, but covering all the sort of things we see in here. Except for Plasteel, I didn't get that one in. Yeah, don't know which one is set for Plasteel, but get all the stuff out of here so the bedrooms can be cleaned up. But I'm thinking about artwork. Was there a place that I had set artwork to be stored? There. You are an awful wooden small sculpture that Klaus made as he was practicing. I think we've gone through this. A burning... That doesn't sound familiar. This work portrays a burning smuggler wearing a suit of power armor. The work has a post-impressionistic feeling and an unbalanced structure. There is a hill in the distance. So things like this could be sitting out there. Let's do that instead. Storage. That didn't do it. Misclicked. There we go. Instead of squirrel skin, let's go to items? Yeah, art. Sculptures. We'll do that. So, critical, get a sculpture in there. It's under a roof, it's not going to degrade, though it is going to be damaged. I think that's the only... Well, we do have another one here. That's a normal. What else is of value that will attract their attention? I mean, gold would, but... Plasteel would. Wouldn't it? I would think so, and I don't think it's going to be damaged that much by gunfire. Let's go that route. Plasteel, where are you? Raw. That looks about right. Right there. Okay, so, long story short, we're sticking something in there to attract people to this area. So they'll be attracted to the gauntlets. We'll see if that works. Another possibility was to open up a... Wait a minute, let me go through my notes real quick. Did I get that right? Consider... There were two possible reasons to do that. I don't see where it was. The other possibility was to attract more traders. That might have been the issue right there, is to attract more traders. Anyway, also opened up a hole in the roof here. What do I want here? No roof area. Over a beacon. I didn't want to do it over this beacon because we'd have outdoor temperatures in here, but over here it'd be fine, just to make sure that an orbital pathway from here out to orbit is there. Whatever we can take to get more traders into this game. If this has anything to do with it, or if it's just simply not that many traders anymore now that caravans are allowed in. Did they just take the number of traders down? Is there nothing that we can do to influence that? So we're going through all of that, but let me think of what other... Well, I did quite a few little changes here and there as per her recommendations. One of them was to go through all of the animals and all of the colonists and make sure that their medication settings were correct. Because over the last, 60 episodes, that's become a little bit randomized, especially with all the gut worms and switching people to the herbal medicines so they wouldn't run out of the real medicine, and then we ran out of herbal medicines and things like that. Our husky turned out didn't have any medicine set for him at all. And I've also, by your suggestion, set him to Roke's animals. So the animals that we don't want going out to combat are going to be attached to someone who stays indoors during combat. Now, Natalia was another possibility, but I don't know if I want animals running the kitchen all the time. You can see how dirty it gets when they're in here. So, just little suggestions like that. I kind of went through and looked things over and optimized a few things. I'm also still playing with our new sapper defense system. The hardest part I'm up against is getting power to these guys. It's not that easy. We need to get power, not on this outer wall where it's going to be blown up and all of a sudden all of our turrets are dead. It's got to be in the inner wall. But switching off the inner wall and not switching off everything connected to it inside is going to be tough. And I'm crossing over main power lines here. So I may have to reroute this power line to somewhere else entirely, maybe out to here. I don't know. So that's going to take several episodes of fine-tuning here and there as they get parts of it built. Let's get this inner loop built all the way through the system here. Figure out where, at what end, maybe at both ends, there could be a switch. That's a possibility. Feed power in from both ends, switch from both ends, hit both switches. They blow it up in the middle. It doesn't take out the other half. It only takes out just that area because it's feeding from both ends. So it could just take out one turret then. That's a possibility. So there's lots of things to think about. How do you make... One thing I do wish they would change. It's great we've got a power switch here. I wish we had a... What would you call it? A bridge? To be able to run power across each other with a jump over symbol. So that we've got two cables across each other but don't connect. Then we could have pathways like this. Main power going in, and turret power crossing it and just jump over. So hopefully one of these alphas we're going to get that. Speaking of alphas, Tynan tweeted today that Alpha 17 is going to be... I haven't even run the game yet, have I? Alpha 17 is going to be mostly bug fixes. In other words, issues that have come up with all the changes from 16. It's mostly going to be just repairing all of that rather than a bunch of new content. But for him to be talking about it tells me that 17 is on its way, as if it's almost in testing. So it may be 18 before we ever get out of this map and get into a current version again. We're at, what is this, 68? I don't know what number we're on now. But I'm hoping by episode 100 we can get done with Alpha 13. It's been a fun series, though. Not a big worry about which alpha we're in. It's mostly right here that's the story. You know, the soap opera of RimWorld. But this is what's going on, and I see I'm 10 minutes into an intro, just getting to where I can start the game up. That's why we're heading for episode 100. Who can come down and give Cassie a hand? It's Turtles. And the whole point of the Turtles was shooting practice. Radar is going to sleep, so can't get him to. So let's kind of look this way. Cassie, as well, who can take on the bear? Oh, I know who can take on a bear. Hey, Dwayne, where are you? That would solve two problems all at once and test my ability to handle all of that in one swoop. Okay, let's go this way. Dwayne. Health. You got your new fancy biotic leg there. And you are over here. Stone cutting. So you're dumping these things off. Okay. If you came over here and kind of got the bear's attention and got it away from Cassie so she can deal with this, that would really be helpful. So I'm going to out of rest. I think you'll be fine. You're having so much, tons of joy and so happy with your bionic body part that and I ate a fine meal. Yeah, you can do with a little bit of exhaustion. Let's draft you and bring you out over here. You've only got that one, but you're pretty good shot. Let me see here. What was you? You're at 4. Oh. But you're a good runner. You'll be able to stay ahead of them. Yeah, you'll be fine. Now, who can help Cassie that's got a pistol? I'm thinking Natalia is one. Where's she at right now? Her bed's down in here. Natalia. Right there. You are playing horseshoes. You're in great shape. You got a pistol. You're drafted. Come on down here and give Cassie a hand. And let's run the list here. Pistols, Cassie, radar, Manuel, character. You're actually a little better. What was Cassie? Let me scoot the map. It doesn't want to move for me. Right there. You're a 7. Okay. Back one and a 7. But I want pistols. Okay. That is it. Okay. So, Manuel, can you come and pick up... Do we have a pistol left? We don't. I thought pistols were aplenty. It's charge rifles that are aplenty. Okay. How much damage does a charge rifle do versus a pistol? Did that work? No, that didn't work. Not you. I want gear. That one. Right-click information. So you do a... damage 13. Okay. A pistol. Gear. Pistol. Information. Damage. 9. Okay, that was the point. Little damage, so they get many more shots in them. I'm going to skip Manuel this time. And just let these two do their job down here. Cassie is running. Can I draft her? I can. Can you fire at? Okay. Cassie, head this way. Not going to get you trapped over there. Okay. Fire at, but who is shooting over here? Cathra is shooting at this turtle. And missing completely! Well, she's only an 8. Okay, I thought she was better. Okay, well, that's her practice run. That's fine. Rokes is doing some repairing, hopefully dodging Cathra's bullets there. Bear is getting uncomfortably close. Hunting tortoise. Whew. Cassie, you got a good run speed. Head up there. Alright, well, he's taking out the tortoise for us. No. Okay, let's not just shoot the turtle out of the bear's mouth. Cassie, let's send both of you two to here. Dwayne, let's leave the turtles for the ladies to practice. Okay, he didn't head after Dwayne. That's interesting. Bear is determined to take out that turtle. Okay, Cassie, you got a good run speed. Hop down here and hop over here and help. This isn't quite going the way I was imagining. Grizzly Bear Revenge. Okay, who you after? You're after Dwayne. That was the goal. Cassie, you head back over here to Natalia. Dwayne, let's take out a grizzly bear. Whoa! Something came blasting through. Do not get distracted. We're a little busy right now. Okay. You got him. And you're taking out the turtle. Nope. Undraft, haul Mr. Fuzzy Wuzzy in. Cannot bury, cannot bury. Will the game pause? Or try that again. Why can we not haul? Someone else has already got the job. That gets me every time. Who? Okay, do that again. No, it's not the case. Cannot bury, cannot haul, no empty place configured to store a grizzly bear. Now, I did make a change here as per more recommendations from the comments of adding a bill to cremate animals that are less than 100 points of quality, meaning it's a way to get rid of rotten ones and have them cremated. Gets rid of any skeletons around, but also gets rid of anything that's rotten that we may have picked up and don't want to make meat out of it. But I don't think this is causing that. So 0 to 90 points is going to be cremated, which there was one or two things in here that were down pretty low. But there really is no more room in here. Wow. Okay, meals? We got plenty. We're going to shut this down completely. And I'm tempted to make a second butcher's bench here. Tell you what, let's do that. Production, butcher, where are you? Right there. Out of wood. Right there. Let's get two cooks doing nothing but butchering. We got plenty of room for it. And I can't believe this is... Well, let's do this for now. Let's storage and allow animal corpses into here. Corpses, animal, and a quality of, or actually hit points of, oh, we'll say from 91 through 100. Okay. Yeah. So now we should have room for Dwayne to haul Grizzly. Okay, so whenever the game won't let you do something, there is a reason. You just have to work your way through it. Now, that turtle got eaten, didn't he? You got a turtle in your tummy. So it's just this guy left. And we're both getting the practice in, which means character, shooting skills. Natalia used to be a 1. So 1622, 1862, 2102. They're going to get lots of practice this way. And there it is. All right, you guys are relieved. Natalia, since you're going back that direction, you're not a hauler. Cassie, there you go. So that's why I did the turtles. Are we still taking out No, I think Kathra got hers. Manuel is taking one out. Oh, good. Okay. Now, he gets... let's watch this for a moment. Does he get points for all three bursts or just for one? So 76-61. And he killed it. Well, he downed it. Maybe we'll get three more chances here. No, just one set of points. So it all counts as one shot. Okay. Still not very good, so he's still getting plenty of chances, but a pistol on him would do better as far as getting his points up. But what I was going to do next were all the squirrels. So, how best to do that so they don't shoot each other? First of all, I don't see a single squirrel in this area. I'm hearing more shots. Ah, Kathra did give up on this one. Okay, so Natalia's getting some practice in there. But before we leave, let's see if we can get everybody pretty well able to hit the side of a barn. Anyway, any other changes that I did in here? I don't think so. Power is almost back up again. I'm deciding what to do here. What worries me the most about this is RimWorld or Cassandra having a timer ticking down right now for the next major event. Me going out here, breaking this, having all this happen, and then one game hour later, Cassandra ticks off her timer and the drop pods start dropping in for a siege. You know, so our last... You know, the Turtle Revenge was not an event. That's something we triggered. The last real event was Alpaca put up a fight for a bear. Was the bugs. And that was one game day ago. We went through an overnight. We went through an overnight for this. Wait a minute. We waited for them to fall asleep. We attacked them. Next morning, I think we attacked them in the night. This happened the next morning, and we're now at noon. So it's been one game day. Dare we dive into this, say, first of next episode, with the idea that I'm doing shorter episodes now? That might be a plan. So what is there to do to kind of finish this episode and clean things up? I did set all of this to be kind of I think I used sandstone, so a nice stone outdoor bench area. And if we do lose another colonist, I think I will shorten this to the smaller table and put another one right there. We'll just make this our memorial zone. But I'm trying to think of what else is going on. This is the biggie. And it's waiting for granite. We do have lots of granite. Let's look at the work orders. Who's building right now? And what are they doing? So Rokes especially. I did, as per suggestion, go ahead and give Eric a research job. Research. Go ahead and stuck Devil Strand in there. Hydroponics I won't do. This is so much cheaper to do. Hydroponics is quite expensive electricity-wise, steel-wise. You lose power, you lose the plants that are in the hydroponics. So, you know, what is that, a solar flare? Yeah, takes out your power, takes out your hydroponics. This is better. Though you still lose this if we're in the dead of winter and we lose our heater. I think they will eventually freeze and disappear. When you lose the light, then... they just stop growing, but they'll remain until the light comes back. But just to give Eric kind of a keep his skills fresh, we'll put it that way. I don't know if that's actually a game mechanism or if that's just more role play just to give them something to do. I don't think these degrade. This is Eric, Research 15. I've never seen them go downhill. But just to get him back into what he does the best. That's, you know, for one project we'll do that. But Rokes is not in bed. Let's find out what Rokes is up to right now. Right there. So you are hauling... Oh, you're building conduits. Okay. So you're getting some of the stuff queued up that I had laid out there, and you're taking it in the priority that the game sets first. I know the game sets, well, at least in Alpha 13, deconstruction is the highest priority, and on from there. So the construction is happening. It'd be nice to have a second person doing it, though. I can run this safely in the background. There's nothing going on, right? I'm guessing Natalia got her turtle. Nettie did. Nettie probably picked up one. She wasn't set to hunting, right? Hunt? No. But who can do some construction? Nettie is set to grow. There's no growing. There will be growing here real soon. In fact, temperatures are looking really good. Let's go ahead and get these turned back on. Trying to catch all the little things I'd kind of forgotten about that need to be done. And here's one of them. Need to get back into next year's growing. All right, so a lot of growing is going to be happening right now. Otherwise, do we pop the box or do we save it for another time and go hunt squirrels? That's kind of where my mind is right now. And everybody is set for hunting. Tell you what, let's continue this pattern for at least one more round. So I don't have to go back and reset everybody. Not going to deal with this area over here just because of all the boomalopes. But there's a squirrel right there. Double click. I get one squirrel. One squirrel. Wow. There's five squirrels. Where are they at? Three of them over here. One there. One over there. All right, we'll do that. Hunt you guys. Let's look at this squirrel. One, two... Just two. Okay, well, we'll hunt those. Let's touch down there. Double click. No more. And that one's toast. Okay, let's look over here. You guys are hauling in various things around here. Rokes probably grab some steel. There's the last of the alpha beavers. Klaus is hauling a... hunting a squirrel. Okay. We've got three queued up over here. Catherine's taking out one. I want to make sure no one's shooting each other in the back of the head. We're looking good here. Snookums and Spirit are after Klaus now. Snookums, who are you attached to? Nobody. Okay. I can't get Spirit off of Klaus without there being a bonding issue. But there's rabbits to go for. Yeah, I don't want to get down in here. Pause. Cargo pods. No, terrible mood. Radar, terrible mood. And we got those cargo pods to go back and look at. Needs. Wow. We gotta do something for radar. This just isn't working. What can we do to get him through this? He's about to break. Can't deal with this. I wish I could tweak his schedule to get him to sleep during the day. It's 4 in the afternoon. When is considered day? Anybody know that? I have him started to go to sleep at 8. Let's kick that down 1 hour. And... We'll do something like that. I don't want to do the whole 8 hours. It's just a trigger point at this time. Well, though if I do that, yeah, okay. I can see that. And this might be, let's see, 18, that's 6 p.m. It shouldn't be beyond that point there. But I think he's sleeping. I'll tell you what might be going on here. He's sleeping in a superior bed. And if I remember correctly, the better the quality of the bed, the faster, the better the quality of the rest. Meaning that their rest is taken care of faster. So having him in too high a quality of bed means he wakes up too early and is still daytime. Let me know what you think of that theory. I think that's correct, but I'm not sure about that. Otherwise, he's about to break and I don't know what else I can do for him. The feeling terrible, I can't, nothing I can do. What does he like to do? He likes to social, he likes to cook. He'll kill us, but you know, disease us, but he likes to cook. He likes to construct, and he likes to mine. We got him out of mining because that wasn't working, but we could get him into constructing. Work. Radar. Construct. If we make that a 2, that'll be the first thing he does other than hunt. Let's follow him around. I don't know when the timer is going to hit. Breakdown, okay. But once he gets outside, his beauty and open space should go up. Needs. So space should go up, which should kick this up temporarily above that line. Beauty is a question whether that'll happen or not. Cargo pods, let's go over here real quick. Alright, that is snow hair meat. And how quickly is it falling apart? It's not yet. Okay, let's go find radar, first of all. And he's outside. These are going up, this is going up. That is going to start moving soon. He's been below his... Let me read this. So mood is 0. Hard mental break is at 5%. Why has he not broke yet? Is it a certain timer that triggers? And if it doesn't go back up before that timer hits, then it finally works? Each time he shoots, he gets a burst of joy. You see that? He says, oh, this is fun. Ooh, this is fun. Ooh, this is fun. Interesting. It's not moving this. But he's sure having a ball doing this. Okay, we'll leave him alone. There are no other squirrels surviving in this area that's going to make him a target, right? Okay, and if he does break, he'll attack the squirrel by hand. Ah, we're starting to... Oh, no, nope, never mind. No, maybe, nope. Okay, we're going to leave him alone. Wait a minute. He will officially now be out of daytime, right? He got his squirrel. Needs no longer night owl during the day. That helped. Still got lots of other problems. What can we do to add green up here, though? That's what I'm trying to come up with. So this episode's going to be over here in a couple of minutes. Tell me what you think. What can we do in this situation? He's got a great bed. He's got a decent room, though maybe the beauty is an issue. You know, that could be it right there. We are going to be cleaning this out soon. They're already starting to move things into these other stockpiles, so this is probably an issue. The dirt floor is an issue. Yeah, he's going to be up for a while. Let's give him some nice flooring. Stone is even better, but we don't have a whole lot. We're using all the granite. That's sandstone, but it's not enough. Okay, let's go with wood. Wood flooring through here. And let me pause a second. Show me a Rokes. Where's a Rokes? Let's get him to work on that right now. Work. Rokes, you are consuming a fine meal. Yeah, I'll let you do that, but I'm going to hang right here. Otherwise, radar is building a steel improvised turret. Okay. Oh. You know, I hadn't thought of that. We don't want those built till the walls are in. Or they're going to be targets. Yeah, that's not going to work. See, cancel is C. Let's take all these out until the walls are built. Because we're just asking all future raids to skip the gauntlets completely. Oh man, I can relocate you, right? Deconstruct, I can't. Nope, that is asking for trouble. I just know it is. Okay, never mind on those. We'll put those in after we've got this built. But... Rokes, I lost you. You're right here. Let's have you bring in the wood. and let's get this done. And if Radar can sleep in a room that has a higher beauty rating, then this beauty will sit up higher for 8 hours while he's sleeping, and we'll boost that up further at night. The more you can make the bedroom better, the more they will get that 8 hours worth of bonus to degrade during the day from all the other ugliness activities, and then they get to recharge again at night. So really, the bedrooms are critical, and I have not been keeping up with that. We were at the beginning. We got to get back to that. Of course, I'm going to give up on smoothing. That's just, word is not going to get there. I'm guessing, from what I've seen of this series, smoothing is the very end of the construction priorities. And you can't right-click and have them smooth. It doesn't work. So when there's no construction jobs left on the entire map, then they will smooth. So we're going to have to give up on that. So after, between episodes, I'll clean those out and put wood flooring in here and get that taken care of. Rokes, you are... Can you finish these? All right, we have lots of wood. All right, let's call this one done. This has been a little maintenance episode, kind of cleaning some things up. Dwayne got his bear, and he didn't have to run from it, though. That's right. Cassie wanted to see a race between Dwayne and a starved charging bear. So maybe that doesn't quite qualify as her requirement yet, but we'll see if we get the opportunity to. Mental state break. Radar has gone berserk. I've not had that happen in the series before. Oh, Radar. Well, that's where we're starting next time. This has been Noble Rambler. Thanks, guys, for watching. No, we're not going to pop the box next time. We're going to pop a Radar. Try to keep him alive through this. Anyway, I'll catch you next time, folks. Bye-bye.